Hello and welcome to the CNBC TV 18's Mumbai Newsroom. I'm Sonal Bhutra and with me is Ekta Batra. You're watching MF Corner. So today, Ekta, we are going to be speaking all about retirement planning. In fact, the Bandhan AMC has launched its retirement fund. It opens, the NFO opens today and closes on the 12th of October. The fund follows a dedicated approach. We'll discuss why it is important to save money for your retirement and who can actually invest in this fund and the other benefits as well. So a lot to discuss.
Well, yes, Sonal, absolutely. And I think that's a very important topic as well. Retirement planning and, you know, getting that corpus to help you live a quality life, especially when, you know, you have healthcare needs and that kind of expenditure to account for at that age as well. But on that note, let's welcome Vishal Kapoor, who is the CEO at Bandhan AMC, to talk about their retirement fund. Vishal, hi, welcome to the show. Well, let's start with the first question, which is very basic. Why exactly is retirement planning critical to start with?
So thank you. Thanks for having me. There are more than a couple of reasons for us to think early about retirement. Firstly, we must recognize that we are living longer. So life expectancy, thankfully, has been going up in our country and steadily so. We are already at 70 years plus, and the number that we have to therefore plan for is well into the late 70s, 80s, not really where we used to be. So we are living longer, therefore we have to fund for a longer period post our primary earning years, and therefore a larger corpus will be required. The second is that inflation has been very high, and therefore, in most cases, the amount of expenses that we have thought about in the past may not be enough. And that's a common mistake that we see as coming through from surveys as well as evidence, where the corpus that we build up often runs short, especially given the fact that we are now living longer. Third, we see around in our society, and a lot of surveys again tell us that we want to now retire early. So the millennials are already talking about retiring almost 7-8 years earlier than the earlier generation. So if you're going to be working for a shorter period and living longer, that means that the number of years required for us to fund during the phase when we are not earning, which is what we're calling retirement, is going to be much larger. And therefore, the corpus expectation that we must have in terms of funding that period has to be sizable. And lastly, I think, when we look around, most of us seem to be overly cautious about our retirement. So even while we are saving for retirement, during our earning years, whether it's a mandatory saving or it's a tax-aided sort of savings plan, we are probably being overly cautious. Again, when we have the deployment of the corpus at retirement, so at 58 or 60 when we retire, the corpus that is given to us as part of this entire plan that we've had during our earning years typically gets deployed very conservatively, largely in fixed income products or NVD products. And at that point in time, it looks like it's adequate to meet our current expenses then, maybe at 58 or 60. But a common issue that we see is that we are not thinking and acting for inflation and the higher medical expenses that we are likely to have post-retirement. And therefore, that can fall short. So our survey is telling us that, most people regret, in fact, 90% above, people above 50 years regret not having started earlier for their retirement corpus building.
Oh, yes. So that is an important thing to counter for or factor for as well. But Vishal, the question that comes is, what is the reason to consider a dedicated retirement mutual fund? Won't the other ways of investment in mutual funds help? There are so many categories already.
Oh, great question. And I think sometimes simplicity and the power of simplicity can be very effective, much more than we think. And, which is where we think that tracking that one folio, that one number that gets you to the corpus that you're aiming for can be a more effective way than getting confused with too much choice and too many things happening. Now, if that one folio, that one product can actually try and give you a much better potential of growth versus what you have today, That may be a fresh way forward in our view, something we'd really encourage investors to try out, because you know that one folio corpus building up through your earning years, and then using that built up corpus to be deployed through very flexible means which a mutual fund can offer through your deployment or your post-retirement years can actually be very effective. So we believe in keeping things simple through that approach.
Okay, can you just flesh through, Vishal, then what exactly would the benefits be of a dedicated retirement MF?
So one, like I mentioned, because it is one plan, one folio, things are simpler. Two is in offering it through the very powerful mutual fund vehicle, and I'm calling it powerful not just because of the convenience as well as the flexibility that a mutual fund offers. But in our fund, for example, we will be choosing a growth-oriented but a dynamic investment option, you know, the balance advantage strategy, as it is known in the industry, where the proportion of equity and fixed income can change based on market conditions. Now, the benefit that we are seeking there is that your retirement corpus, when you're in the, you know, in the accumulation phase, so let's say between your 20s and you know, till the time you retired, maybe in the late 50s or early 60s, that's a long phase, and that corpus does need the benefit of growth assets like equity, something like I mentioned earlier, which seems to be largely missing when we look at, you know, the aggregate retirement pool that seems to be deployed today. So a growth-oriented or a balanced advantage strategy, we think, may be very appropriate for that period, providing both the benefits of stability through debt, but also the growth potential of equity based on market conditions. Now, once you get closer to retirement, that money can actually continue in the same folio for some time, because keep in mind, at 60, a lot of us think that we now need a steady income through an annuity, but actually we still have to fund for maybe 15, 20, maybe 25 years of further expenses where inflation has still to be beaten. And there again, a bit of growth is useful, in fact, necessary. And the same folio being used for an SWP could be a very effective way for you to actually manage your expenses, have the flexibility, be able to, you know, also look for emergency corpus through the very easy, you know, exit mechanism that mutual funds give you, but also give you growth. So that's one huge advantage through a simple folio, through a retirement fund.
Okay, so let's talk about Bandhan's retirement fund then, Vishal. What will the breakup be like? What will the asset classes be where you'll invest?
So we will look at a combination of both growth and growth assets like equity as well as debt. We will model it based on the dynamic asset allocation or the balance advantage principle, where based on the valuation that we see for equity, you know, the amount of equity allocation can go up and down. The balance will be in debt. So therefore, the benefit is you have growth potential of equity. You also have the stability of fixed income. And you know, market variations over the longer term can actually be used to your advantage, which many investors have benefited already through balanced advantage funds. Being a vehicle which is growth oriented, it will have the benefit of equity taxation. So therefore, it's tax efficient as well. And like I mentioned, because it's a mutual fund with all the benefits and convenience and transparency, as well as the regulations that mutual funds come under, it gives you all of that benefit as well. So in one sense, you know, again, our survey tells us that most people know that they need to plan for retirement, but just either the lack of information or too much choice or just getting confused with the terminology actually holds us back. And therefore, simplicity is important. And just being with, let's say, this one folio and saying, okay, let me build my corpus and focus on that, rather than getting too worried about, you know, am I here or there, etc., maybe one approach.
Okay. Well, you know, Vishal, if you could just tell us, how important is dynamic allocation when it comes to investing for retirement?
So dynamic asset allocation has two benefits. One is that, you know, from a technical standpoint, the risk-adjusted return that can offer across cycles can actually be quite superior. So as we all understand that equity markets are bound to be volatile, And therefore, risk-adjusted return is a good measure for us to think about or look at, because you know, not being in the market right through can be a challenge, but being entering and exiting at the wrong time can also be a challenge. So these are things that equity, pure equity strategies may suffer. On the other side, it's very important to also look at behavior of investors. And I think a lot of studies have told us that the volatility of pure equity strategies actually can scare most of us who are looking for a bit more of a steadier ride. And that's where, again, behaviorally, balance advantage strategies have become very popular, because as investors are moving from a very conservative approach, which is where they currently are in most of their retirement thinking, to a slightly more growth-oriented approach, we think that a balance advantage strategy which combines both growth and equity and fixed income in a dynamic manner can actually serve the benefit or serve the purpose much better.
Okay, Vishal, we'll continue this interesting conversation on the other side, because we have to get into a commercial break, and we'll continue our conversation on retirement funds and a lot more. Stay tuned for that.
Welcome back to MF Corner. We still have with us Vishal Kapoor of Bandhan AMC to talk about their retirement fund. Well, Vishal, you know, one of the other questions is, what exactly is the expected rate of return for this particular fund? What can we expect?
As you know, predicting any rate of return is definitely something that we, we are not able to do. But if you were to look at historic returns of allocations like this, a balanced advantage type of a product or a 50-50 allocation between equity and debt, what we've seen in the past is that one should be able to generate returns in the region of 10 to 12%. That's happened in the past, and in one sense, again, the idea for us is that the retirement plan should be able to beat inflation. And if that is something on a post-tax and post-expense basis one is able to actually deliver, that would be a good outcome. And certainly when we look at some historic returns of similar strategies, that seems to be the case. And that's where, coming back, if most of your retirement corpus is deployed in just pure fixed income, on a post-tax and post-expense basis, the returns may not have been as attractive. On a balanced advantage product or the index of 50-50, allocations have been quite attractive on a relative basis. And that's why we think that this is not something which is overly aggressive, neither very, very conservative. Most retirement plans tend to be very, very conservative, and which is where we think, beating inflation is going to be an important part of the objective of this fund. And a double-digit return would actually be able to, do and get you that best of both worlds, in a sense.
Okay, all right. So in that case, Vishal, tell us, who would this fund be suitable for, and who should not be looking at this fund for investment at this juncture?
So Sonal, to be honest, when we look at the data of how our retirement corpus is deployed today, and this is both with us who are employed today and are therefore saving towards building up our retirement corpus, it's just too conservative. So the risk we run is that we are not taking risk. And because we're not taking risk with our retirement corpus, most of it is deployed with PPF or traditional fixed income products, or we bought a traditional insurance plan, for example, to try and build a corpus. That's unfortunately not going to do justice to the compounding benefit you can get from Indian equities, which is why we think that this should be something that you're looking at as your retirement plan, as the primary corpus, whether you're 25 or whether you're closer to 60. Now, the other interesting thing is that at 60, when you're actually, getting that corpus and looking to deploy it, we once again see that most investors or most savers are being too conservative, where they end up deploying most of that corpus in traditional fixed income alone. And like I discussed earlier, if one is looking to now plan for 15, 20, 25 years even, you have to take a bit more risk and be in growth assets. And that's where this one single plan can actually help you across both these phases, whether you're 25 or whether you're 65 or 70.
Okay. All right. But Vishal, you know, one key point is that there's a five-year lock-in. So do you think that because of that lock-in, the investor could hesitate from investing into the fund?
We see that, Ekta, as a very important and beneficial feature, actually, because firstly, the five-year lock-in applies only if you're not at retirement. So it's five-year or retirement age, whichever is earlier. So if you are 58, then it's only 2 years. If you're 60, then there's no lock-in. So that's one benefit. So if you're using this fund to deploy a part of your retirement corpus as part of the growth assets of your retirement corpus with all the flexibility of a SWP or just a redemption lump sum, et cetera, then this does not apply. But in your accumulation phase, I think there is adequate data now available in the industry, including that published through our industry body, AMFI, which suggests that our typical investor behavior tends to use equity assets in a very, very short-term, tactical sort of way. So the bulk of equity holdings tends to be about, less than 2 years, actually. So at one level, we all understand that equity assets should be looked at longer term, at least 5 years. But, the behavior seems to be contrary to that, unfortunately. Most of us seem to be redeeming equity assets too early. And a five-year lock-in in that phase gives you that discipline, that seriousness about building your corpus, and hopefully plays across the phase when markets can be volatile to eventually deliver you a return that you are reasonably more satisfied with and gives you the confidence, therefore, to continue. And that's behaviorally one of the things we are trying to solve here, that while the theory is all there, why aren't more people actually participating in equity for their retirement corpus? And hopefully the five-year lock-in feature can help you overcome that hesitation.
Okay, take that point. And rightly said, the AMFI data did suggest that in the equity fund, at least the retailers are redeeming it before 2 years. Vishal, it's been an interesting chat. Would have loved to chat more, but completely out of time. But with that, we'll take your leave on this edition of Mutual Fund Corner. But stay tuned for Closing Bell to take you through the last hour of trade. Thanks a lot for tuning in.